just finished filming the video on how I made this skirt, and it took me 4-ish days, so excuse all of the wardrobe changes. From here, I am moving on to jewelry making, so if you have any ideas or suggestions of what you'd like me to make, leave it in the comments down here or back on my blog. And don't forget to thumbs up this video and subscribe. And if you have any other ideas for future projects, just want to say hey, leave it down here in the comments. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye. First, I started by measuring my waist, and then I multiplied that by 4, so that was the measurement of the length I wanted for each layer of the tulle. I ended up with 6 layers of tulle at 4 times my waist. The tulle comes on the bolt folded in half, and I didn't want it to be a floor length skirt, so I just cut the tulle at that fold mark. After I had all 6 pieces cut to length, I started pleating each layer. This is a super tedious step, but it's really important so that the skirt can look nice and fluffy and full on the top. So I just folded each pleat, pinned it, and then I'm gonna sew 2 rows of stitches. The bottom row, I use the tightest stitch, and then the row right above that, I do a really loose stitch. That top stitch is what helps kind of cinch it together a little bit and made it my waist size. Now that all of the layers are pleated and stitched, I cut a piece of scrap fabric to use as the waistband, and then I begin pinning and sewing on the first layer. For the second layer, I sew it on in the opposite direction. It kind of looks like a butterfly if you're looking at it. That way, whenever you're finished sewing it on, you can fold that layer down and it looks a little more puffy on the top. I'm gonna just continue alternating sewing on right ways and wrong ways back and forth for 5 of the 6 layers. Unfortunately, my camera wasn't rolling for this next step, but as you can see, I pinned on the ribbon that's used as the top band. And what I did is I laid it down and then I pinned the top layer backwards like I did with the second layer and sewed it so that way whenever you fold on that top layer, it kind of is hidden by the tulle, if that makes sense at all. And then after that, I get really excited and then I'm going to go ahead and iron the band. I really liked it nice and tall, but it was too flimsy that way, so I just folded it in half and I didn't want to put pin holes in it, so I'm using pin curl pins to improvise and hold it together while I sew. Now when I sew, I'm doing it very, very, very close to the tulle without touching it. I don't want that seam to be visible really at all, and the puffiness of the tulle on top sort of covers up that line of stitching. Here is the full skirt with all 6 layers without the liner. So for the next step, I am hemming the liner. And then I'm going to go ahead and pleat the liner as well, just like I did with the rest of the layers of tulle. I wanted it to still be puffy and full, even in the liner, so I went ahead and did that extra step. Then I pinned it onto the band underneath all of the layers of tulle and got to sewing. After all of that, I had to figure out how to sew in an invisible zipper. I've never sewn in a zipper to anything ever, much less an invisible one, so this was pretty challenging for me. I didn't really read the instructions, I kind of just winged it. So here I am folding the seam for the back and I'm pinning it up and I'm just gonna sew the 18 inches, that's the length of the zipper. And this turns out to not be the right idea, but it ends up working out in the end. So I'm just sewing on each side 18 inches down and leaving the rest open. Now with the skirt turned inside out, I'm pinning the zipper to each side. And now just checking to make sure that it actually unzips, because that is, you know, useful. And now I'm just sewing each side of the zipper up each side of the skirt. Now I'm pinning up the rest of the opening that is not part of the zipper. And just don't even ask what I'm doing here. Just don't even ask. So back to business. I'm gonna take those pinned areas for the back and sew them up, and then we're finished. This was the most fun and most challenging project I've done so far. I am so happy with the way that it turned out. It's not perfect by any means, but it turned out better than I could have even expected. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you guys think. And I will see you next time. Bye.